break actually means to break their spirit. You can't control an elephant with a hook or a chain unless you first break their spirit. You chain them, you break them, you teach them that they depend on you for everything they need. The amount of suffering those elephants, and the tigers and the lions, but the amount of suffering those elephants go through in order to entertain anyone's five-year-old for 15 minutes is a crime. It is absolutely inappropriate for the American people to allow Ringling to continue traveling these animals and putting them into...
Barnum & Bailey Circus have agreed to pay a $270,000 fine for violating federal animal welfare laws. However, Ringling...
Asian jungle as they can be. Sadly, one of the only things they can use to entertain themselves in these pathetically boring concrete corrals is the very chain Ringling Brothers uses to shackle them to the ground.
Trade of the circus with us today, but Tim was told that he would be arrested and put in prison for 20 years if he brought a bullet or a stun gun into the chambers here. So.
Good evening. I'm Micah Ullman with you at 6:30. According to the County Health Department, this is LA's biggest outbreak of tuberculosis in a decade. At this point, it is primarily confined to the Skid Row area, but authorities are worried the disease may spread. Carolyn Costello live in downtown LA with more. Carolyn.
Well, Micah, homeless people tend to go undiagnosed, therefore untreated. They also tend to be transient. So the goal is to identify anyone who's been infected and treat them before they leave the Skid Row area. That's why the CDC has been called in to help. Now, we are just a couple of blocks from Skid Row. We're in Little Tokyo. People who live and work over here want to know tonight, should they be concerned with that outbreak so close by? The tuberculosis outbreak is happening here, LA's Skid Row, where health officials say more than 4,600 people have likely been exposed. It's a highly contagious infection that destroys lung tissue. It's then spread when that tissue is coughed, sneezed, or laughed into the air. It can spread quickly throughout the homeless population, where many people go undiagnosed and untreated, live in close quarters, staying on the street and in shelters. But should people living and working just blocks from Skid Row be concerned? Dr. John Martin says no.
It is easily spread, but in general, it's not something that's so easily spread that people can routinely catch it just by walking down the street and passing somebody. It's something that's more often spread by people that live close to each other that are getting frequent exposure to the respiratory droplets.
However, the homeless population is often transient, many moving from city to city and state to state. So identifying the people infected and treating them as soon as possible is a top priority for the CDC.
Once you've been on treatment for a couple, 3 weeks, you're really not contagious anymore. Mm-hmm. So the key to minimizing the impact of the outbreak is to identify people that are infected and get them treated as soon as possible.
Tuberculosis can spread beyond the lungs throughout the body and can be deadly if left untreated. If it's diagnosed in a timely manner, people are treated with a cocktail of antibiotics for 6 months or longer. I am told that if you do begin treatment, you are no longer contagious after 2 to 3 weeks. Some strains of TB are antibiotic resistant and therefore cannot be treated. I am told the strain here, a couple of blocks from here on Skid Row, is not resistant to antibiotics. So again, that is why the CDC is sending in scientists to identify people who are infected, get them treatment as soon as possible. Reporting live tonight from downtown Los Angeles, Carolyn Costello, KTLA 5 News.
It's the Circus.
Very much, Honorable Mayor and Council. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to speak. My name is Kelly Sawyer. I am a native from Orange County. I was a child performer at Disneyland. I posted several links on your Facebook page this week attempting to inform you about federal trial information and the things that came out in that trial with Ringling Brothers. What I'd like to discuss today that everyone seems to keep avoiding, including Dr. Dennis Schmidt, who spoke here this evening, is that Center of Elephant Conservation, which is the Ringling home for all of the elephants, where they breed the elephants and where the performers, Mabel, who was here this summer, was, well, it's in regards to tuberculosis. It's under quarantine since 2007. It is indefinite because this human contagious tuberculosis has mutated. You can check Harvard studies. Please check the CDC. There was an elephant symposium last year in 2011. They have had two outbreaks from elephants. 11 people were infected in the last one, and they did confirm that it was from the elephants, NIOSH, a special division of CDC. So anyway, some of the elephants that were here, the testing right now for circuses is inadequate. They're doing trunk washes, and that's not adequate to test. They don't have, the diagnosis is not down. They think that the elephant tuberculosis originated actually from circus workers, which is why it's in captive elephants. So this is a new ground of elephant study. Dr. Schmidt would be able to fill you in because he published a 15-year study of tuberculosis treatment in Ringling elephants. It is experimental somewhat because they don't know how to control it. It is human contagious. The CDC says your best bet is to wear certified respiratory gear when you're in shared air. They are unsure if it does live in the environment for 8 months. In dust and dirt that is kicked up, it can live and remain there. They're unsure about public environments, how long it is contagious there, and whether it is shed through fecal. So there are all kinds of unanswered questions. And Mabel, who was here this summer, was born to a positive infected mother, Shirley, who was never ever allowed to leave CEC again. She's under permanent quarantine. And they were not treating her in a federal court deposition. They were not treating her when she was nursing Mabel. That's the number one way to get tuberculosis is through milk. So I would recommend before any of these elephants come back to the city, please check with the public Department of Health. They have access to records that you cannot get through the...
Ms. Sawyer, ma'am, your time is up.
Okay. CDC states it's could be the final conqueror of mankind. It's a very serious issue, and there are several articles stating that it is contagious to the public. Please check with the CDC.
It's the circus.
Yeah.
Don't stop. It's the circus.
Thank you. don't feel